Hello students of standard 9th, welcome to DAV Moyle Public School. I am your English teacher Jagruti Mishra. Let's begin our today's online session of English. Dear students, today we will continue with your word and expression book, Unit 8, second part. Vocabulary. Suggest a word from each sentence or phrases correctly. Refer to the chapter Reach for the Top, Part 1. Given in your textbook behind. The paragraph numbers where these words are used are given in the brackets. A state of happiness and satisfaction. For this you have to find the word in paragraph 2. So the word in paragraph number 2 for this phrase is contentment. Final stage of something you have been working towards in paragraph number 7. And the word is culmination. In the same way, dear students, refer the paragraphs and find the words. Fill in the blanks using the words given in the box. These words are taken from the chapter Reach for the Top of your textbook behind. You can refer to a dictionary to find out the meanings of these words. A. She wears expensive dresses and jewelry. It seems she belongs to an affluent family. In the same way, dear students, fill in the blanks. Third, playing with the words. How many words you can make from the words given below? For example, from vocal we can make vocal gods. From labor we can make labored. In the same way, you can frame new words from these two words. An idiomatic expression is a group of words with a special meaning. The individual words in the expression do not mean what they otherwise stand for. For example, Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed or categorized her talent. Unwavering desire to succeed and readiness to sacrifice have lifted her to the top of the world. Here, pigeonhole does not mean that there is a hole for the pigeon to its nest. But it means that someone or something belongs to a particular type or group is categorized, especially without knowing much about them. Now, consult the dictionary and match the following idiomatic expressions given in column A with their meaning in column B. Already, dear student, first is done for you. Next part is grammar. In the chapter Reach for the Top in Beehive, you have read the two clauses in a sentence have their own subject and a verb or verb phrase. One part of the sentence or one clause tells us why or when something has happened. Example, I read Sherlock Holmes while I was on holiday. It was raining heavily when I got home in the evening. I will phone you when I go to the clinic. Can I borrow your book when you have finished it? Now, match each of the sentence which with halves given below to make meaningful sentences. He was found guilty of drinking while he was under the influence of alcohol. In the same way, try to match the remaining ones. Match or make one sentence combining the two statements given below. Example, it's getting dark. Let's go home before that. So how we can combine this sentence? Let's go home before it gets dark. Here are some more examples done for you. She must clean the room. I won't enter the room until this is done. I won't enter the room until she cleans the room. Evening came, they rested. They rested when the evening came. In the same way, dear students, join these two sentences. In each of the following sentences, you have to remove or add a word or a phrase to make the sentences grammatically correct. Write the correct sentence in the space given below. Dear students, these sentences are grammatically incorrect, so we have to make it correct. Maria Sharapova likes to be dancing, singing and fashion. Here, likes to be is wrong. To be will not come with likes. So the sentence will be, Maria Sharapova likes dancing, singing and fashion. She put with insults and humiliation in order to realize dream of becoming a tennis star. Here, some words are missing. So, what are those words? She put up with insults and humiliation in order to realize her dream of becoming a tennis star. So, here two words were missing, up and her. In the same way, dear students, try to finish the remaining ones. There are spelling errors in the paragraph given here. Correct the spelling errors and rewrite the paragraph with appropriate punctuation mark in the given space. Awake, arise and educate, smash traditions, liberate. Dear students, read the paragraph very carefully and correct the spelling errors and rewrite it in your workbook, or you can write it in your copy. Dear students, here we end our today's session. We will continue with the same unit in our next session. Have a nice day. Thank you.